Why, hello again, biology learners. Welcome back to Lab Day. Today we're going to be looking at fermentation, specifically alcoholic fermentation in yeast. So I don't know about you, but I love to show up at the grocery store right when those big loaves of French bread come right out of the oven. I could literally just stand there and just eat that entire thing. Just crack it open and pull out all that bread. You know what? I'll be right back. Hold on. Oh no, I gotta do this first before I can go to the store. So anyways, the thing I love most about that bread is its light fluffiness and that great bread smell that you get. So how do all of those air holes end up in that bread? Well, it's the yeast. When yeast are doing alcoholic fermentation, they are making not only ethyl alcohol, but they're also making the gas CO2. Now, when we bake the bread, the ethyl alcohol gets baked off, but the CO2 is what leaves those nice fluffy bubbles in our bread, makes our bread nice and light and fluffy. So today we are going to be investigating which sugar yeast likes best. And we'll know which one it likes best because that'll be the one that produces the most carbon dioxide. So the sugars we're testing today are glucose, which is a monosaccharide, dextrose, which is also a monosaccharide, and we're also testing two disaccharides, lactose and sucrose. So when you get back to your lab, you're going to see you have a baggie that has 5 balloons in it, and you have a piece of string. You also have a little sauce cup that has exactly 5 grams of yeast. So this is enough for your 5 balloons. You want to make sure you make very good measurements. I have an empty sauce cup, which is going to be my tear cup. Remember back to the gummy bear lab, we're going to use a tear cup. I have a balance. I have a ruler. I have Sharpie. And I also have a graduated cylinder. So first thing I'm going to do when I get to the back is I'm going to get my balloons and I'm going to label them. So I've labeled this balloon here. This is going to be my glucose balloon. So I'm going to label my balloons glucose, sucrose, lactose, dextrose, and then water, because that's going to be our control. So once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and get my tear cup. I'm going to put it on my balance and zero it out so that my balance doesn't see the cup. And I'm going to measure out 1 gram of yeast. So I'm going to measure 1 gram here. All right, so I got 1 gram of yeast. I'm going to take my balloon that says glucose on it, and I'm going to pour that yeast. I'm going to pour that yeast into the balloon. Maybe. Let's see here. My cup's a little fragile. These cups should be bendable, so you should be able to do this without breaking them. So let me pour my yeast into my balloon here. Now, there's going to be some static issues, so you might need to use your finger to help it along a little bit. All right. So I got my yeast in my balloon. Okay, it's hanging out in there. And now I'm going to go ahead and get my glucose solution. Now, all of your sugar solutions are hanging out in a water bath because we're trying to keep them to a certain temperature. Yeast likes warm temperatures, so we're trying to make sure your solutions stay there. So I'm going to grab my glucose container. So you can see it says glucose here. And I'm going to measure out 25 milliliters of glucose using my graduated cylinder. Go. All right. I'm going to take these 25 milliliters and I'm going to pour it into my balloon that has the yeast in there already. All right. Now, I don't want any excess air in here. Remember, we're trying to do anaerobic respiration, so we want to get rid of the air. So I'm going to squeeze the air out, and then I'm going to go ahead and tie this balloon off. Okay, I'm going to squish it so I get that yeast and glucose all mixed together, and then I need to make a couple of measurements. First thing is I need to mass this balloon. So I'm going to put it on my balance, find the mass. That is my initial mass of my balloon. And then I need to measure the circumference of the balloon. So I'm going to take my string, and I'm going to measure. Here, I need a helper, but I'm going to use my mouth. No, that's not going to work. I'm going to measure around the circumference of my balloon using my string, and then I'm going to use my ruler to figure out what that circumference is in centimeters. So right now, the circumference of my balloon in centimeters is about 10. So I'm going to write that down for initial circumference. Now I'm going to repeat this for all 4 of my other balloons, including my control balloon, and then I'm going to let them sit for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, we'll come back and see which balloon is the biggest, which means that yeast preferred that sugar and made the most carbon dioxide. I hope you enjoy the lab and don't eat the balloons.